Today we again see a 3D representation of a riveted joint, which is a butt joint. Okay, I'll give you a briefing of how exactly the positioning of sheets will be there and how we need to place the straps, single strap, double strap, all these arrangements we'll see. Today I'm going to take the session for 40 minutes. Okay, please concentrate. Again, I'm going to share this SolidWorks window, which you are all familiar with. SolidWorks 2017. In this version, I try to give you briefing of a butt joint. Okay, we'll try to make use of already existing sheets. Okay, now I'll just open, which I have already explained you while discussing a lap joint. Okay, this is sheet number one and opening. It will take some time. Some more students are joining. Okay, this is sheet number one. For your clarity, for your information, what I try is I'll show you all the dimensions related. This is sheet number one. Have a look. Now I'll go to the sketch of sheet number one so that you have a clear picture of what exact dimensions are maintained. Now sheet number one is having 4 mm thickness, nothing but T value. T is equal to 4 mm, which is given in the question, let us assume, and a width of 50 mm. Remember, a width of 50 mm we have considered for the session. And other than this, we'll see what exactly the extrusion value is. Now the sheet got extruded, means material got added up to 500 mm. Okay, if you want we can cut down, but as of now I'm just keeping as it is. This is the information about sheet number one, which is having dimensions of 500 by 50 by 4. I hope I'm clear. Let us go with sheet number two. I'll show you sheet number two also. This is blue color one. I kept it in blue. Sheet number two. Okay, and now our intention is to join these two sheets with the help of a rivet, snap headed rivet. Now again, let us go through the details. Now it is again maintaining, this one is maintaining dimensions of 100 by 4 mm. All right, now this 100 by, let us maintain uniformity, where I'll mention this also 50 mm. Okay, because there in sheet number one we have maintained 50 by 4, so same thing I'm maintaining here also. Just have a look. So let us have a look at the extrusion, means material addition. Now material addition is up to 400 mm. Let it be. Okay, there it, in sheet number one it has maintained about 500 mm. Okay, now we are not bothered about length, or we are not bothered about the width of the sheet. We are only bothered about the thickness and the area where exactly rivet is going to sit. All right, let me save, changes, close. So coming to the snap head, now what should be the in between height of two snaps, that we need to make sure. Now let us confine ourselves to a single riveted butt joint. Okay, single riveted chain butt joint. If it is a single riveted, you are going to have a thickness of whatever the thickness given to you, sheet thickness. For our session we are considering it as 4 mm, 4 mm thickness followed by the strap width. If it is a single strap, then we consider it as T1. If it is a T1, what should be the dimensions of T1? T1 is equal to 1.125T. Let me take a sheet and explain you. Here we are considering it as, now let me be very clear here. We have few specifications to be remembered. What are those specifications? We'll see now. T value is given to you, which is equal to 4 mm. All right. Now we need to know about two things. One is T1. What is T1? That is important. What is T2? This is also important. This is already given to you in your text, but most of you get confused, like where to use, how to use a question mark. T1 is equal to 1.125 T. T1 is equal to 1.125 T. T2 is equal to 0.75 T. Okay, these are the two specifications, that standard specifications that we need to remember. Okay, now when you know the thickness value 4 mm, only thing is we need to substitute. Okay, we need to substitute in 1.125 T to get T1. So 1.125 into 4 will give you a value of 4.5. This is equal to, if I substitute T, then I'll get a value of 4.5 mm. 4.5 mm. Again, this is equal to 0.75 into T. This becomes 3 mm. This is fine, we can easily calculate, but the question is where exactly we need to use T1, where exactly we need to use T2. That is the question. Now you know from the basic information which I have given while discussing 2D representation of riveted joints. Let us consider this as sheet number 1. For your understanding, I am changing the color of the sheets. This is sheet number 2. Okay, now this is called a butt joint. I would like to use a strap over. This is the strap, nothing but a sheet, thin sheet, which will help you to catch hold of these two sheets. Okay, single strap. Okay, now where what I can do here is I can simply place a rivet, one this side and one to the other side of the butt. Okay, this is the other side of the butt. Here I'll try to drill a hole, place a rivet from top to bottom with the help of a hydraulic or pneumatic press. I get the snap head of this kind. Okay, now again same discussion will continue with a double strap. This is your sheet number 1 and this is sheet number 2. I'm changing the color just to make you understand. You people no need to change colors, you need to draw with pencil only. Few more students are joining, let me take them in. And a strap over here, this is strap number 1, and with the same dimensions I'm considering one more strap. It all depends on the working environment where exactly you are trying to make use of this arrangement. Okay, based on that you need to plan things. All right, now again I'll try to place a snap headed rivet here. Internally there will be a hidden line. Of course I need to draw a hidden line here also, I've forgotten to do that, but I hope you understood the concept. This is one more snap headed rivet here again. This is fine. Okay, now here you could see this is, we call it as a single strap butt joint, single strap, single riveted butt joint. Okay, what is that? Single rivet, that is fine, because you need, whenever I'll say single riveted in case of a butt joint, you need to consider only one side of the butt. This is the butt joint, so only one side, if you could see, you could see only one single rivet, means one single row. Try to understand, single riveted, single strap butt joint, this is the name you can give. Okay, similarly in this case this is also a single riveted, but this time here you have two straps, double strap, again it is a butt joint. That is only difference is single strap but double strap. This terminology you should understand, because that will be given to you in the question. The question may be of this kind: draw the representation of a single riveted single strap butt joint by considering T is equal to 4 mm. If T is equal to 4 mm, accordingly what you need to do, you need to calculate D value. D is equal to 6 under root T. Now we know T value is given to you. 6 multiplied by 2 will give you a value of D which is equal to 12 mm. Now you need to consider this 12 to calculate all others parameters related. Now for example, what is P? Pitch value in case of riveted joint, P is equal to 3 into D. That is equal to 3 multiplied by whatever the value got, 12. Okay. So this is the P value. 36 is the P. Means in between two rivets, you need to maintain a gap or pitch distance of 36. This is important now. Now we got all the specifications almost related to butt joint. Thickness is given to you. This is a given value. Let me write it down. Given value. So I have calculated T1 and T2. Now the question is whether you are working on a single strap joint or a double strap joint. That is important. Now coming to our discussion, we are discussing about a single strap. If it is a single strap, what should be the thickness? Now here it is maintaining thickness is T, which is equal to 4. This is fine. And how about this thickness? Now this thickness is supposed to be how much? 4.5. Okay, 4.5. For example, if you are working on a double strap, then the top strap thickness is 3 mm, bottom strap thickness is also 3 mm, which is which we call it as T2. T2 is equal to 3. Here also T2 is equal to 3. In between you have a sheet of 4 mm. Okay, whenever they ask you to draw double strap, then only consider T2. Whenever it is a single strap, consider T1. Okay, now we are supposed to take 4.5 mm for our discussion. Okay, let me share that window again. Now if that is the case, what should be the in between snaps height? In between height of this particular circular shaft means 4 mm plus 4.5 mm. 8.5 should be the height. Let me show it. Okay, 4 mm plus 4.5. So the in between circular shaft height should be 8.5 mm. So you have to plan that way in your drawing sheets also. Try to understand. Now let me cross check what exactly the dimension maintained for this particular snap headed joint. This I have developed while I was explaining you about a lap joint. Alright, let me show you the dimensions of the sketch. These are the dimensions. Now let us check out the height. It is 17.50. It is supposed to be how much? 8.5. Okay, when I consider this as 8.5, other specifications are changing. So let me trim the unwanted things. This is not required now. Alright, and let me draw a single straight line maintaining a height of 8.5. Alright, it got fixed now properly. And let me draw this line also. Because unless in this software, unless you close the entity, that will not convert into a 3D model. That is the main problem. Okay, now it got fixed properly. Alright, let me come out of this. Have a look. there is an error here. Let me check it out again. All right, now let me mirror. I want to mirror all these entities to the other side. This is a problem with the arc. Let me delete and redraw this arc. Now mute yourself, ma. Somebody unmuted. Okay, I hope you people are listening to me properly. I'm developing a 3D snap headed rivet, that's it, nothing else. All right, now let me fix these dimensions. Now what should be the snap head diameter? It is supposed to be how much? 1.65 into D. Okay, 19.8. So this radius, let me keep it conventional. Let me keep it 9. 8 would be okay. When you get some number in fractions, then you can make change of it. Doesn't make any difference. Now what should be the diameter? 12. So 6 is the radius, it is fine. Now let me mirror these entities to the other side. Got it. Done. Okay. Now I'll join them all to get the half cross section of a rivet. Actually, these all discussions are not required for you. These all related to software. Okay. But as of now, I'm discussing, I'm making you understand. Okay. This is how a snap head is going to be. Oh, okay. This 8.5 has to be maintained in between only. So for that, what I try is, all this stuff is not required. Directly what I try is, in between I'll try to drag a line I'll just try to draw from the midpoint. I'll try to drop a line. This line will help me to mirror the entities. These are the entities to be mirrored about this line. Got it. Close and remove unwanted. This is not required, and this is also not required. All right, this is how rivet is going to be, and let me remove all these lines and make a single stroke line. From top to bottom, I'll just drop a straight line. Just that. I'll just come out of it. Close. Delete. Yes. Now this is a sketch we have developed. Let me go with revolve. With respect to axis. Done. This is the rivet developed. Now I have taken this much of editing because I would like to maintain a height of 8.5 only, because 4 mm is the thickness given and 4.5 is the strap thickness which we have calculated, T1. Let me save changes. This is done. I'll consider one more sheet. I'll consider one more sheet by the name strap. Let me take this strap on screen. Okay, now this is the strap, and we will need to maintain the thicknesses properly. Here the thickness need to be maintained is how much? What should be the thickness? 4.5 is the thickness, strap thickness. This is done. Okay, and what should be the width. It is 120. There we have taken it as 50 by 50, 100 mm overall width. I mean both the sheet width is 100 mm. Now let me confine, we'll reduce this to some 80 mm. Okay, this is 80 mm, or else let it be the same. Let me increase to 90. Okay, conventionally drawn sheet. Now these two holes are maintaining a gap of, I'll show you that one also, a gap of 36, which is 3D, and the diameters are of 12 12. So because in between from the butt, I'll again show you that, have a look here. What should be the distance from the center midpoint of the rivet till the butt? What should be the resistance? This is supposed to be 1.5 D, and this side also from the center of butt to the center of snap headed rivet 1.5 D. So overall it is going to be 3D. So that same 3D we have considered in between two holes of the strap. Done, got it. Okay, let us save the changes whatever I made and go to the assembly module. I'll go to the assembly. This is important, ma, have a look. My idea is to make you understand this logic, how exactly we assemble the model. I'll bring this snap sheet number one again, I'll insert sheet number two somewhere here. I'll try to place it. Now remember, we are not working on a lab, we are working on a butt joint. Now for that, what I'll try to go with mate option. I would like to align enlarge this face of sheet number one with this face of sheet number two. Okay, this is fine, but these two faces should also align, this one with this one. Done. And this edge fix. Done. Just have a look, properly arranged. Oh, but these two are misfiring here. The hole should fall parallelly, but because of sheet length, it has changed its positions. Okay, now again what I try here is, I'll just try to bring back sheet number two again, this is sheet number one, inserting sheet number two, this is sheet number two. Let me go with mate option, it means I'm trying to align both of them, this face with this face, aligned properly. And now this circumference of hole with this circumference. This edge with this edge. And this face with this face. Then I'll maintain a distance. What should be the distance? Now there is a gap. Let me take it as some 291 is the distance, 100. Further, only idea is why I'm changing these dimensions, means I would like to match the holes, these two holes in a parallel direction, these two holes with mate. So I'll try to decrease the number. I'll try to keep the model in top so that I can understand better. Okay, again it is misfiring. So here what I try to do, I'll try to change the number by 8. By 12. 13 is the number that you can understand easily just by looking at both the circles. So here it will take even. Yes. Okay. Both are aligned properly. Just have a look. All the circles are aligned properly. Now only 10 minutes left ma for the session. Please try to concentrate. I'll show. This is the model. Okay. When I keep the model in wireframe, you could see circles here and here, both are aligning properly. Just have a look. This is a 3D representation. Done. Now I need to place a strap over on the top of it. Okay, so let me say okay to this and insert a strap. Let me take a strap. Open. Strap is placed here, and now I need to arrange, because directly you can't place a rivet on this sheet or this sheet, because it is a useless task. Okay, so in case of a lap joint, as the sheets are placed one over the other, you can place the rivet directly. There is no use of a strap. Whereas in case of a butt joint, you need to place an aligning sheet over it and you need to fix it. That is important. Now I want to coincide this with this one. Okay, just have a look what I did now, just now. Don't bother about the length and width of the sheets. Don't bother about this side of the sheet or back side of the sheet or this side of the sheet. Only try to concentrate on what is happening here. Okay, this is a butt joint. I'll just try to keep it in wireframe so that you'll understand. Here is a butt joint. Over it there is a strap. There is a strap placed. That is what I am trying to show. Alright, this is the arrangement we made. Now this strap will help you to catch hold of both the sheets. So what I need to do now, I need to bring a snap headed rivet. Oh, before that it got inserted. Yes, now have a look. Okay, the sheet number, the strap is penetrated into sheet number 1 and 2. For that what I do is simply this surface should be this surface. Done. Now I have lifted it. I have lifted it properly. Done. This is also okay. Let me bring the rivet. Now this, have a look. This is important. I am bringing this rivet here and try to align properly. I want this circumference to be coincident with this. Just have a look. As I have maintained proper dimensions, I could see that. Now here there is a gap. That gap need to be fulfilled. Now rotate slowly this with the top surface. Done. Okay, similarly I'll bring one more snap headed rivet and do the same operation. This circumference of rivet should be in contact with this. Done. Yeah, here you find a gap. That gap need to be removed. This surface should be in contact with this surface. Done. Now it is properly learned. Now again I just try to place in a front view so that you'll understand. This is what you do in case of a butt joint. What is the kind of practice we do? I would like to join these two sheets. For that I'm taking a help of a strap which is maintaining a thickness of 1.125 t. okay, so this top strap is having a thickness of 4.5, and below whatever the sheets, two sheets you want to join, having a maintaining a thickness of t which is 4 mm. okay, and there are two rivets. Let me keep it in wireframe for you. This is how you need to draw. Why you got these hidden lines means because the rivets are placed away from the front edge, placed away from the front edge. That is the reason those are hidden. Let me give clarity here. Have a look. Between the observer and the rivet there is a material, so that is the reason this internal shaft is not visible. That is the reason we'll keep it in wireframe model. Okay, I hope you understood. Got it? Now in the same way what we'll try to do industrially, if you'll see, we call to one side of the butt there is one row, single row. That is the reason we call it as a single riveted single strap butt joint. We have taken single strap. If you call it as a double strap, same strap will be placed to the bottom side also, but the thickness you are going to maintain is t2. Try to understand. Okay, similarly we'll try to place number of rivets in this row. You might have 1000 rivets or 1 lakh rivets need to be placed. So manually to place those many number of rivets in a single row might be a problem, because manually if you'll try to do the kind of practice, then there might be an error of 1-2 mm. So what they do industrially means they'll write a program, and with the help of a robotic arrangement at a distance, pitch distance of 3D exactly, accurately, rivets are placed. So for that you have an option here in software also. What I want to do is I want the same rivet to be placed in the row at a distance of in this direction blue color one. Have a look, this blue color direction I want number of rivets to be placed, and I will fix the instances also. So here at a distance of 36, which is 3D, and I want number of instances. Number of instances means depends on number of requirement or number of holes. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12. So there are 12 instances required. This is also fine, but which feature you would like to mirror? So this is the feature. I want to change the direction. Just have a look, all the rivets are placed. If I decrease the number, it will come down. Okay, this is the first rivet and I'm increasing the number of rivets. I hope you could see. I'll enlarge and show you. 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, got it. Let me say okay to this. Okay, all the rivets are placed. And again here also I'll repeat the same task. I'll go to linear patterning in this direction, 3, and this is supposed to be the 4. Okay, I want to change the direction. Have a look, I just increase the number, all the rivets are falling accurately in its position. Okay, so 13 is enough. Okay, have a look, all the rivets are placed. Now both the sheets having a thickness of t are properly fixed with the help of a permanent rivet. Just have a look. Okay, after placing 13 rivets or 14 rivets or 1000 rivets also, when I view from the front, what I could see is a single rivet because all other are falling behind. So that is the reason we are calling it as a single rivet. Towards one side of the butt joint there is a single rivet, single row. That is the reason we call it as a single riveted butt joint. If you have one more rivet to the other side by this, you have one more rivet, then we call that pitch as PR. If it is a chain riveted, we are working on a chain riveted joint, so PR is equal to 0.8 p. if it is a zigzag, then we call it as a PR is equal to 0.6P. Zigzag in sense, one more rivet will fall in between the gap at an offset distance of PR, which is P by 2, and PR is equal to 0.6P. That information you have in your text, please go through it. Okay, this is what the arrangement I would like to show you. In the next class, we'll work on zigzag arrangement if you don't understand, and also drafting this particular model. Okay, I hope you understand. If you have any clarity, if you want any other clarity, you can talk to me now, because the time left is very less. No need to rejoin again.